Okay, so now I've left the most annoying thing for last. I've got to deal with leap years. And my campaign to eliminate leap years has not been successful. So we've got to figure out a way to figure out if it's a leap year. And the rules for leap years are pretty complicated. Let's see what Wikipedia has to tell us about that. This is quite interesting. You can see how accurate the solstice is over time as the leap days go. But the great thing here is it actually has code. And it's not Python code, but it's pretty close. But this is a very clear way to describe the algorithm for determining whether a year is a leap year or not. If it's divisible by 400, then it's a leap year. If it's divisible by 100, then it's not, if it was not divisible by 400. If it's divisible by 4, then it's a leap year. Otherwise, it's not a leap year. So let's turn that into code. I'm going to cut and paste that so I can see. If I was doing this with a smaller font size or a larger screen, I could see that at the same time, so I wouldn't have to cut and paste it. But it's a good thing to have as a comment anyway. So all we've got to do now is turn that into Python. And I could do it in a straightforward way. I'm going to be a little bit lazier and save some typing by doing it in one line. Let me reconsider. I'm going to try to get this right the first time. We'll use a few more lines of code, and I will follow what Wikipedia says more carefully. So if the year mod 400 is equal to 0, we're going to return true. It is a leap year. If the year mod 100 is equal to 0, we're going to return false. It's not a leap year. If the year mod 4 is equal to 0, we're going to return true. And if not, well, we don't actually need the else because we've been returning. We're going to return false. So let's test that. And if I wasn't thinking this was simple, I would probably write some special test cases to test leap years. I'm going to just do it by hand with a few test cases now, because I think there aren't too many difficult ones. So 2000 is divisible by 400, so it should be a leap year. 2100 is not divisible by 400, so it should not be a leap year. And 2012 should be a leap year. And 2013 should not be a leap year. So I think I'm fairly confident that I got that right. So now we're going to try to put that into days and month. We need to change the case for days and month when the month is February. Now we need to check the year. And if it's a leap year, we return 29. Otherwise, we return 28. And I don't need the else here. I'm going to put the else in just to make it look more balanced. Okay, so now let's run our current tests, make sure we didn't break something. They all finished. That's a good sign. Let's add some tests that depend on leap years. So we're going to test the next day for February 28th. It is a leap year. And we should do some long year tests. The number of days in a leap year should be 366. So I've got those two. Let's also add the test that we did by hand. And let's see. And the tests all passed. And now we should try running it on the test that were provided.